So are you excited about this big party?
Oh, I'm very excited. I can't wait to, I don't even know what all's going on. I've been retired from the music business for almost 10 years now. My longtime friend, Clint Higham, came to me with this idea of a tribute album. I was so honored, not just for me, but honored for my family, the songwriters, musicians, all the people who helped build my career.
Mom, the car is here!
Let's go, guys, come on.
Thanks so much, Earl. Oh, y'all look pretty.
Ready?
The biggest names in country music have come together to sing my greatest hits.
I wonder who's gonna be there.
This tribute party today is in my honor, and it's a reflection of my music career.
Mom, how does today make you feel?
Like it all started yesterday.
Straight leg Levi's, flannel shirts even when they want to style. I remember singing with Roy Rogers at the movies when the West was really wild. And I was listening to the Opry when all of my friends were digging rock and roll and rhythm and blues. 'Cause I was country when country wasn't cool. Ooh, I was country when country wasn't cool.
Yeah. She was country when country wasn't cool. A tribute to Barbara Mandrell with Dierks Bentley, Kenny Chesney, Terri Clark, Sarah Evans, Blaine Larson, Reba McEntire, Lorrie Morgan, Willie Nelson, Randy Owen, Brad Paisley, LeAnn Rimes, Gretchen Wilson, and CeCe Winans.
What's it like to have the biggest stars in country music paying tribute to you on this album?
I don't have the words to describe how I feel about all these amazing stars. Each one, they're huge.
Girl,
how are you?
I'm excited.
I am too. Oh.
I am so flattered that Sarah is singing on my album.
I'm honored to be doing this.
Oh, thank you. It's the other way.
Hope
thank
I can
you.
Do it justice.
Dennis Morgan and Kai Rhonda Fleming wrote for me a song called You Can Eat Crackers in My Bed Anytime.
That's an old statement that people have said for years, you can eat crackers in my bed anytime.
I had never heard the expression in my whole life, and I thought, that is so clever. And then Kai and Dennis, of course, told me, no, that's an old saying.
You can eat crackers in my bed anytime, baby.
It was a challenge to make it really innocent and fun.
I thought it had all of the commercial things that are needed to be a hit. It was memorable, it was cute, it was fun.
You can eat crackers in my bed anytime.
When they called me about doing this project and they said, you know, you have to pick a song, that was my first choice.
For its time, the tracks, the arrangements, it was really great, and it was really hip. Now it's a little cutesy, Sesame Street-ish sounding to me. I can't wait to hear what you're gonna do.
We knew that we wanted to slow the tempo down to make it a little more funky and more contemporary.
Believe me, we're going to mess with it.
That's half the fun.
Hopefully not mess with it.
I'm sorry I said the things I did.
I loved her and listened to her music all the time. She was very glamorous, very stunningly beautiful, very sexy.
You can eat crackers in my bed anytime.
Her live show was so energetic. At the time, there was nobody like her.
She really forged the country performer into different areas rather than just stand there with a hat on and sing the bell of hay.
What I took from Barbara Mandrell was that I can do more than just be a chick singer.
You can eat crackers in my bed anytime.
something about that song always kind of made me go, ugh, because the thought of, you know, crackers in your bed, but then the fact that you would let someone do that says so much.
I loved with all my heart the reaction that that song received from children.
I'm dedicating this song to my 3-year-old.
It was a big children's song.
Well, I'm trying to think of where we could put in apple juice too.
They like
the song.
That.
You can sleep with a window open wide. Do
anything as long as you're by my side. No one who knows anything about country music could ever forget about Barbara Mandrell. She is such a staple in country music. I think she deserves a project like this because she was such a phenomenon.
She's very special, so this is a great compliment to me. I'm very thankful.
She's a legend. She really is.
Coming up, LeAnn Rimes sings a country music and R&B classic, and a young Brad Paisley takes the stage. And later, Reba McEntire and Kenny Chesney. The stars.
Kai and Dennis, once again, just struck a home run for me when they wrote In Times Like These. I thank the good Lord I've got
you in times like these.
It's a great song. Who could want anybody other than Brad Paisley?
I remember I had two favorites when I was in, like, second grade, and it was her and the Oak Ridge Boys. That was the two biggest acts in country music, really.
I think it makes me feel like I'm all that when I think about Brad Paisley recording and the song he chose to do.
You gotta be careful as a guy, you can't sing all your songs.
you didn't want to do Woman to Woman, did you?
No, I didn't. That didn't appeal to me at all. There were several of her songs, and one in particular that I used to sing a lot, Times Like These, that I would sing that with my first band when I was, I think, 12. And you gotta see it, it's hilarious. I'm wearing a sweater vest and Reeboks.
You were real cute, weren't you?
Well, yeah, I was. So I have that video somewhere, so you can insert that.
I want to see it.
Yeah,
I'll
see it. Get it to him at this point. Sitting on the front porch, rain is pouring down. Listening on the radio, there's trouble all around. That's the way it's always been. The way it'll always be. I thank the good Lord I've got you. In times like this. Well, she was one of the first female instrumentalists to do really well. I remember when I was young and watching her jump from steel guitar to bass to banjo to whatever on stage. I couldn't believe that somebody could play all those instruments. I forget how many. What is it, 20? Something ridiculous like that.
It was never as difficult for me to get to each instrument as I possibly would make it look like it was. It's just something one does to make things more exciting.
The joke was when we decided to cut a song for this record, my producer said, well, you ought to have to play everything. That ought to be the rule, you should have to play every instrument. Unfortunately, it wouldn't be much of a tribute at that point.
I'm kind of overwhelmed that he is doing this. He is a great singer, but he is a fabulous musician too. I mean, he does it all.
It's good that we're recutting some of this for a new generation to hear, because I think there are a lot of these new kids now that she's been retired now for, what, almost 10 years. They don't know who she is in that sense, and they need to know.
He sure sang the fire out of it on this album. It's great.
She really is one of kind.
I love R&B music. And Luther Ingram had a great song called If Loving You Is Wrong, I Don't Want to Be Right. And even though it was a cheating song, I had been known to sing some cheating songs. And I really loved it, and Tom Collins loved it. And so when the producer and the artist are really in agreement on something, we couldn't wait to take it in the studio. Loving you is wrong, I don't wanna be right. Loving you is wrong, I don't wanna be right. The musicians on that session they laid down the most rock solid smoking track. I mean, that track is great today. Am I wrong to give my lyrically, just a stone cold cheating song, but it's the power that I think country music possesses, and I think R&B possesses in that, and they just tell it like it is, just shooting straight. But the melody, it was something that a singer could really wrap their chops around. If loving you is wrong, That's why I got very excited that LeAnn Rimes would be singing this one.
Loving you is wrong. I don't want to be right. If being right means living without you, I'd rather be wrong than right. My mama and daddy...
LeAnn.
Hi. Oh.
You sexy woman with a sexy voice.
Oh, that's so fun.
Isn't that? That sounds fun.
I love
fun.
That song.
I was just hanging out with her at the gym one day. She asked, and I said, why not? I mean, this would be fun. And I love her music, and I love the song I'm doing. It's such a really cool vibey, really special song.
She made it so sensuous and so for real.
There's definitely, you know, an underlying country kind of tone, but there's so much soul to it, and that's what I love, and that's what I try to do with my music, so I think that's
true.
Her music really knew no boundaries. I mean, she was country, but she wasn't, and she had a lot of soul.
I was 10 when I started working professionally in country music, and that's a very neat, special thing about LeAnn. She started as a young girl working and being a slam dunk, I might add. Golly, she's talented.
I work out with this girl at the Delta, at
it
the
feels
gym.
Weird. They're actually working
this
together.
Is a lean, mean, fighting, singing machine. I mean,
I love Barbara so much, is why I decided to do this. I love seeing her at the gym and hanging out, and I love her as a human being all outside of who she is as an artist. Why I decided to do it more so than anything is because she asked, and she really wanted me on this.
I just want you to know I will forever be grateful to you.
It was an honor. This was a real honor.
Thank you.
We should all strive to be the entertainer that you've been, and the human being, and the great woman that you are.
Oh, gosh, thank you.
Her voice and her songs, they should never be forgotten. I just respect her so much as a woman and as an artist also, but even more so as a human being, I think is even more important to say, because she's just an incredible, incredible person.
Up next, Dierks Bentley takes us down fast lanes and country roads. And later, Gretchen Wilson sings Barbara Mandrell's first number one song.
When I heard about this project, I definitely was excited to be asked about being a part of it because I'm a fan, you know.
How are you?
I'm so happy to see you.
Jake,
come here,
come on over here, buddy.
Not only a fan of hers, but just of country music in general and the history of country music and all the great people that have come before us.
You're so beautiful.
Fast Lanes, Country Roads, just a song that I think anyone can relate to that plays on the road and spends a lot of time being busy out there, then wanting to come home and just kind of get away from the rat race.
The fast lane for a country road.
Really
I can't wait to see what you do.
We're trying to figure out how to kind of make it our own and still keep the magic of what you guys did in there, but we're having a lot of fun with it. Has a little more edge to it. It drives pretty hard, but it was a great arrangement she had, and we just tried to make it our own.
There's an 8-lane highway out in LA, headed nowhere.
Brought the guys in that I share the stage with every night, and really just try to make it feel like something that we had written. It's a big deal. I mean, there's a lot of great people on this project, and we're just excited to be included. So it's gonna be fun.
Thank you very much,
Dierks.
It was perfect. I loved it.
For a country road. Yeah, I'm gonna take a turn for the better. It's been a long, hard ride.
She has that quality, whatever it is, that you know, when she's on stage, her eyes are drawn to her. Whether she's playing an instrument or just singing, you know, she's so talented to begin with, but also just really just an entertaining quality that you sometimes can't really learn. That's just something that you're either born with or not.
It's a great compliment to have a fresh, young artist want to record one of my songs.
Barbara Mandrell definitely had a big part in the history of country music. She's been doing it for 38 years. It's a pretty amazing longevity. It's up there with George Strait.
Hey, Jake.
Jake.
Hi, Jake.
Say the word S-Q-U-I-R-R-E-L.
Squirrel. Country road.
Lorrie Morgan has such a rich, mellow, earthy, expressive quality about her voice. It's very full. And when she sings a line to you, you absolutely flat out believe her. And I'm very fortunate that she's saying that's what friends are for, because those lyrics are very, very heavy.
She was my friend.
I've been a fan of Barbara since I was a little girl, and I remember her just being this bigger than life, but yet this tiny figure that was just so powerful and beautiful and sang songs that I loved to sing. And so when I was asked about the project, I was so happy to be a part of it.
That's what friends are for. And there were times.
There she is.
Hello.
Oh, Lorrie. I'm excited. I'm thrilled.
I am too. You're not gonna be here when I sing, are you? I love sad songs, always have. There's just something that moved me more than the bubbly songs.
I was so pleased when you chose to do That's What Friends Are For. You could just read the lyrics out loud on paper. And it's the most gorgeous, like the most beautiful poem.
I suppose I should have seen what was happening to me.
I remember the first time when I heard That's What Friends Are For, it just broke my heart. I don't even know if that time I could relate to the song, and maybe I've never been able to relate to it, but I'm telling you, it is a song that totally moves my heart.
Now there's only me.
Instead of doing this huge production and spending all this money, I said, let's just go in and do it raw. Let's do the song like real country music used to be done.
She was my friend when I needed a friend.
Everybody felt it, the musicians, everybody. It was just so magical. And what you hear is how it goes down on the tape. And we did it, we pulled it off.
And there were times when she was feeling down. One of us would always come around and try to share some of the happiness we found. That's what friends are for.
That's I learned a lot from watching Barbara, as I did many of my idols. And I used to watch you, how you would run out on stage on the Opry. You would take off and you would run to the center microphone. Seemed like she was never afraid to try things. And I guess that's kind of what made me have confidence, you know, that it's okay to try something. And I can remember her, you know, messing up a couple times and watching her smile and laugh about it.
Now there's only me.
I feel like I had a great teacher in you.
Oh, gosh, thank you very, very much.
You're welcome. She'll always be remembered as being friendly, vivacious, always smiling, and very sweet. And I really am honored to be doing this. I can't tell you. When they said, would you do it? And I was like, are you kidding? Yes, I will do it.
If that's what friends are for, I don't need them anymore.
Next, Terri Clark delivers some fan mail that she wrote when she was 13. And later, Kenny Chesney and Reba McEntire.
She's a true star in every sense of the word. And this special will show you why.
Because I was country, and country wasn't cool.
Barbara Mandrell is stepping out. Monday night at 10, 9 Central on GAC, Great American Country.
Terri Clark and I first met when you, Jamie, and I were doing that Diagnosis Murder show.
I got a little bit part on the show, and she was uh, She had a very big part on the show.
She just was so bubbly and kept going on and on with all these nice compliments.
I just got really goofy. I was just, you know, I didn't really know what to say.
She made me feel 12 feet tall.
It's so nice when you meet the people that you feel helped shape who you are as an artist.
Terri.
Hi.
Hey, girl. Come here.
You really want them to be cool and nice and great, and when you meet them and they are, it's just like, oh, a big sigh of relief.
I'm very excited that you're doing this.
Oh, I'm excited too.
I heard about it from my management company, and they said they'd like you to do Sleeping Single in a double bed. I said, that's fine. I mean, I know them all.
Chose doing Sleeping Single.
Well, I like it. You know why it's good for me is because it's rocking and it's tempo and it's fun.
It's also one of the biggest hits she ever had.
Dennis Morgan and I started writing together for Barbara, and that was our first number one with Sleeping Single in a Double Bed.
Sleeping Single in a Double Bed.
I think Tom's grandparents, think it was a conversation about they slept double in a single bed.
Did I know that it was going to be a success? Yeah, it couldn't miss.
We turned it around, Kai and I, and that title was so strong.
We rearranged a couple things, and I don't care if anybody else likes it. All I care about is that you like it.
Single in a double bed. I'm sleeping single in a double bed. Thinking over things I wish I'd said. I should have held you, but I let you go.
I've had a blast cutting it. I brought my road band in and I produced the track, and I think it turned out really well. You know, we made it our own, but didn't stray too far from what Barbara did on her recording. And
I just enjoyed listening to Terri Clark's and her band's version of Sleeping Single in a Double Bed, and I gotta tell you, it's great.
Just drinking doubles alone, don't make it a party.
This is a letter that I wrote to Barbara when I was 13 years old. This is actually the first draft, because I did several.
She, in the studio, handed me one of the three letters that she wrote to me when she was 13.
I wrote this to you when I was 13.
It says, this letter is for Barbara Mandrell.
You are my most favorite actress, singer, TV star, etc. I tape record every Barbara Mandrell show. It is my very favorite show. See, this means this letter is not for Barbara Mandrell's people.
Oh, it's private. For, that means private?
Yeah. I have your records, the best of Barbara Mandrell, Love is Fair, and I am getting live. I have enclosed my school picture.
Is this for me to get to
yes,
have?
Yes, yes.
Well, thank you. Gosh, thank you.
Well, it was meant for you in the first place,
thank
so
you.
I may as well give it to you now.
Pretty wonderful.
I'm sleeping single in a double bed, making over things I wish I'd say.
I'm honored to just be a part of this because I realize what she's meant to country music and to entertainment in general. And I think it's important that we honor the people that influenced where we are, and all the people on the album that are doing what they're doing. I'm sure we're influenced by Barbara Mandrell in some way, shape, or form. You look at the other legends in our industry like Waylon and Willie and Reba and Dolly and Barbara, and they're all people that were their own person and did their own thing and didn't follow the crowd.
In a double bed.
I love Terri Clark.
Well, my hand is getting tired, so I better go now. Ciao, from your good friend, Terri Clark.
When my daughter Jamie said to me that one of the cuts on the album, she sure wished it would be He Set My Life to Music, there was no question. I wanted CeCe Winans to do it.
She's an incredible person. And so when I was asked to be a part of this CD, I was honored.
And it's the final cut on that album because nothing can follow it on the face of the earth. It was just blessed.
He set my life to music. He gave me words to sing.
Even though this song was written for Barbara Mandrell, it's definitely my testimony as well.
To me, without a doubt, God put my life on the path that it took.
Without God in my life, I wouldn't be who I am. My faith is definitely the most important thing.
Anytime I forgot to pray about stuff and thought like, yeah, I can make the decisions. Those were the only times that I got in trouble.
Really, God is the one I sing about, and He's the one that adds melody to my life.
Here's my God. Oh, CeCe.
Hey!
Oh, my goodness. Oh. I'm so elated that CeCe is the one singing this song. And you are such a blessing that he's given me. Thank you.
Well, you've blessed the whole world for years.
Do you?
And every time I see you, it's just a light. It's just a nice little light. Mm-hmm. I'm going to talk to Barbara about her retiring because I don't think that's fair. I don't think that she should retire. She might not care what I think, but I'm going to tell her anyway.
The only time I sing is sitting in the pew at church with, you know, that's it.
Really? Mm-hmm. As long as you have that wonderful instrument that God has given you, I think you're cheating the world when you're not sharing. I think she sees all the different artists that's a part of this and how excited we were to be a part of it. Shows her that we have been touched by her life, by her gift, by her talents, and that we really do love her.
If God said, Barbara, I'm taking you home in 5 minutes, the last thing I'd want to hear, it would have to be Mississippi Mass Choir or CeCe Winans, Andre Crouch, somebody that just takes me to a whole nother place.
You saved my life.
Coming up, Gretchen Wilson and Alabama's Randy Owen. And later, Reba McEntire and Kenny Chesney team up to perform Barbara Mandrell's signature song.
For the Barbara Mandrell tribute album, She Was Country, When Country Wasn't Cool, featuring one of Barbara's biggest hits, sung by Kenny Chesney and Reba McEntire.
When country wasn't cool,
hear LeAnn Rimes, Brad Paisley, and Sarah Evans, all performing Barbara's smash hits. She Was Country When Country Wasn't Cool, a tribute to Barbara Mandrell. To order now, call or go online.
Just this album. I mean, as a fan, I'd heard him on the radio, but I didn't know him.
Oh, how are you doing?
Good. How are you?
Oh, I'm great.
Good to see you.
His I Wish That I Could Fall in Love Today is tight.
This song came about because Clint Heim, who's the executive producer, he thought that this would really fit me the best.
It's just a great rock solid country song.
And when I heard it, I was like, this is it.
When Blaine took hold of this thing, it just really, really hugged me and blessed me.
It just fell into place and it felt right and it was kind of magical.
I wish that I could fall in love today.
I've never been asked to do anything like this before, so it was an honor. And for me, it's so cool. I don't know how else to say it.
He upheld and gave a wonderful feel to a lot of the old traditional licks and arrangements, if you will.
Each night I pray, I'll wake at dawn and find.
But that's not all. I mean, he took it to new places. He gave it his own wonderful feeling.
I tried to just cut it like I would do it for my record. I'm really happy with the way it turned out. We took some bits and pieces from the original we tried to pay tribute.
Did you enjoy doing it?
It was fun.
It's a happy song, isn't it?
It is a happy song.
Help me out.
You're one of the people in this business that I just can't get over how talented, how many different talents, how many things you can do that you're so good at.
Through the years, different young, new recording artists that I've met. From time to time, there's been maybe a little bit of example or advice or something that I might share with them. Or certainly if asked, I would. Because people were nice enough to help me and tell me stuff. Show business is a fun life. It's a very tough life, as you know already.
Mm-hmm.
You have to sacrifice a lot of things. A lot of your personal life you have to sacrifice. Mm-hmm. But the rewards are great. It was a little special for me. With Blaine in the recording studio.
Thank you for letting me be a part of it.
No, thank you. You blessed me. In fact, I gave him my phone number saying anytime at all, you ever want to discuss anything, or do you want a sounding board, a shoulder to cry on, somebody to celebrate with you, whatever, you call. That's my number. I'll be there for you.
I wish that I could fall in love today.
You'd have to have not ever lived on the face of the earth to not know of the great things that Alabama did.
and the many, many accolades and awards they received. Why? Because they were all that.
Randy.
How are you?
Oh.
I love Alabama, and I love Randy.
I don't even know what to say to you. You made me so happy. This is just
you're going to get to me.
Thank you so much.
He's a really good person. And he was the first person to record on this album.
I was so excited when he told me that you said you wanted to sing yours. And I just thought, how perfect, because you appreciate good songs.
That's a country classic forever, years.
A really great song is usually a real simple song. It's really simple and says the words and it gets the point.
I think now with Randy doing this, there will be millions and millions and millions, especially of women that will just go absolutely nuts over it, you know.
Don't put too much pressure on
this. Okay? I appreciate you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
We're going to work hard for you.
Thank you.
After all this time, you'd think I wouldn't cry. It's just that I still love you. After all these years.
I am proud of the fact, though, that they were a guest on our Barbara Mandrell and the Mandrell Sisters series.
At that time, you have to go back to those years. I mean, it was impossible almost to get a, quote, country act on network TV. It expanded our industry, and she was the face of that, and she brought the grace and the dignity and the looks and the charm and everything to that. And so it was a win-win situation for country music.
I leave the hall light on.
He's a real person. He truly is. He's deeper than what we see, but in such a good way. It just endears him even that much more to those of us that are privileged to know him that way.
She's probably the entertainer that ever was as far as country music.
After all these years.
Billy Sherrill, my first producer, and what a giant in country music. He played me a song that was written for guys called The Midnight Oil.
And I guess I'll have to burn the midnight oil again.
It said, well, I'm putting on my coat and tie. I'm putting on the one that really loves me. I went nuts over this song. And I said, I want to do this song. You got to rewrite it for me. Well, he said, well, what do women put on, you know? So I started thinking, okay, dresses, shoes, makeup. He went, well, I'm putting on my makeup. I'm putting on the one that really loves me.
While I'm putting on my makeup, I'm putting on the one that really loves me.
When I found out that Gretchen Wilson was going to record The Midnight Oil, and that's the song that she wanted to do and be on this album, I went, yeah.
Hi.
Hi.
Can I hug you?
Yeah. They asked me if I wanted to be a part of it, and, you know, I was shocked, really.
I mean, how perfect, because Gretchen, her songs are so, like, hit the nail on the head. I mean, she comes right out with it.
That calls from the office, and I guess I'll have to burn the midnight oil again.
When I found out the song, you know, I thought, well, that's perfectly fitting for me. You know, it was a risque kind of song then. It still is.
I don't think there'd ever been a woman sing a song where she point blank said, I'll cheat.
When I laid the vocal down for it, I was thinking, man, this is almost, I was trembling a little bit singing it, because it goes beyond even like any of the songs that I've written. Like when I think about cheating and stuff like that, and they don't quite go there. I felt like I was cheating singing it, you know?
I know.
While I'm putting on my makeup, I'm putting on the one that really loves me.
And the marvelous thing about being a recording artist is that you get to live out so many fantasies in life during your 3 minutes that you're singing a song.
It was interesting for me, you know, it was, and I really had to put myself in a different place to be able to pull that one off.
You know me, the only thing I do is go to work and watch TV.
I tried not to change it up very much at all. I just tried to believe it.
And I watch him in the mirror as I lie to him. I don't know how late I'll be.
I don't like going back and singing songs that have been done that well. You know, I mean, if it ain't broke, don't fix it, you know? So it was tough for me to want to change anything about it. I didn't want to change anything. I just wanted to do the song justice for her.
She was fantastic.
And tonight I'll cheat again. And tomorrow I'll be sorry.
When I think of Barbara, I think of entertainer, you know? I think of a woman who was unstoppable. I think of a woman who didn't take no for an answer and did exactly what she thought was right for her. It's important to pay tribute to her and everyone like her. For me, and I would hope that for a lot of the newcomers to country music, you know, that it would be important for them too. Barbara is one among many legends that we need to always respect and admire and take care of and do anything that we can for.
I'm putting on the one that really loves me.
Next, Reba McEntire and Kenny Chesney sing I Was Country When Country Wasn't Cool.
There's nobody more important or more special to me that could have done my signature song. Reba and Kenny, they were the best and they were my choice.
I Was Country When Country Wasn't Cool is a signature song. I mean, it's Barbara Mandrell's song.
To sing someone's signature song is a little bit of pressure, I have to admit.
I was country.
Well, the number one reason why it's important for me to do this album for Barbara was because I love her.
How are you, darling?
Oh, I'm so happy.
Oh, I'm happier than you are.
Second is because I want to sing this song with Kenny Chesney.
This is just too good to be true.
You look great, Barb.
Oh, thanks, Reba. Oh, you
don't get out. And third, I will be on the bandwagon waving the flag for Barbara Mandrell any minute, any time of the day.
I love them both so much. This is a very special day for me.
I think today I'm just going to approach that song by singing it with all my heart. And whatever comes out of my mouth will be from my heart and with tons of love for Barbara.
I remember wearing straight leg Levi's, flannel shirts even when they weren't in style.
My first memory of Barbara and first time I was introduced to her was her TV show.
I watched her, how she, her mannerisms on stage, how she had made eye contact with not only the camera that was filming, but also the audience.
Rock and roll and rhythm and blues. I was country when country was.
She was the ultimate entertainer, and there's guys and girls like me every day that if they haven't learned anything, they should.
I don't know if you have enough time for me to tell all the things that I learned from Barbara. But when you see me, you say, ah, I taught her well.
Oh, yeah, right. Yes. Yeah, right.
You taught us all.
I'm her student.
Take pride in knowing that I learned, you know, from her how to connect with an audience and how to, you know, make somebody feel something.
I remember seeing her open the show for Mickey Gilley. It's Cheyenne Frontier Days Rodeo. And the next night, they were both on, and they flip-flopped. He opened the show, and she closed.
Oh, I was country when country wasn't cool. Yeah, I was country.
Before she announced her retirement, she called me, and she said, it's going to come out tomorrow, but I wanted you to know first. I'm hanging up the microphone. I said, oh, why, you know I'm not. You're not either. What are you doing? You got some big thing you're planning? She said, no, I'm gonna retire.
Barbara can say she's retired, you know, but, you know, God gives you a talent and you can't give it back.
And I was really sad for all the upcoming female artists, the other girl singers coming up, that aren't gonna get to sit and watch her and study her.
She may be technically retired, but I bet you that deep down in her heart somewhere she's not.
Yeah. I've been, up there,
I've been personally at George Jones my whole life. Might as well do it right here. I'm excited to be able to sing with Reba so much because I've always wanted to.
Where we're all free to choose.
And it just worked out great that we get to do it for Barbara.
Country wasn't cool.
Hey, I'm Sorry, George.
Yeah, I was country from my head down to my boots.
Oh, yeah, love it.
I'm sure if George Jones were here with me right now, he would also say that he's pleased, very pleased that Kenny Chesney is joining Reba McEntire in this song where George joined me. Country wasn't cool.
I don't think I'd be where I am today if it wasn't for Barbara Mandrell.
Oh, I was country. Oh, when country wasn't cool.
It was because of Barbara Mandrell that I put peanuts in my Coke. That's the truth.
My name is Clint Higham, and for those of you who don't know me, I have the extreme pleasure of getting to executive produce this project. Nearly a year ago, I approached Barbara, and she was out gardening and mosaicking and totally retired for 9 years now. And I said, we need to do something and help salute and honor you. I really think that Barbara has been taken for granted, and you're talking about a woman who was the first person to ever win the CMA Entertainer of the Year Award twice, the only female to have ever done it twice. She is the entertainer by which all entertainers should be measured. She sets the bar. Ladies and gentlemen, the chairman, Joe Galante.
In a short time, you'll hear the record here and see the result of working on that. But it absolutely has been a joy for us. And Barbara's excitement throughout this entire process has been inspirational to all of us. I know that Barbara wants to also recognize a very special person, somebody who has been in her life from the very beginning, her manager, her dad, Irby. I'd like to share with you what will be the album cover of this project on a lady that is still country and is still very cool.
I remember circling the driving, pulling up and turning down George Jones. I remember when no one was looking, I was putting peanuts in my coat.
I didn't know she wasn't touring. I always think everybody is, and they never call me when they quit.
You're not like me and saying, I'm tired, that's it.
Oh, I've been tired so many times. I quit, you know, it's like drinking. I quit three times one night, still went home drunk. I'll have to ask her how it is to lay off 10 years, and when's she coming back?